J'ai tout poil. Elles ne partiront pas.
That is the glass roof of the Grand Palais. And this is the obelisk brought from Egypt. I have almost arrived at the end of the Garden of the Tuileries. Tuileries. And out there, before the Grand Palais, is a huge plaza known as Place de la Concorde. Twenty years ago, it was known as Place de la Révolution. And before the revolution, when it was first laid out about 40 years before that, it was known as, either Plaza of the King or Royal Plaza, I've forgotten which. But it was Louis XV who built some buildings over there that you cannot see except for the roofs through the trees. He built with his own bare hands. He carried all the mortar and stone on his back. The poor king. No. He ordered to be built the great buildings that face this plaza, which we cannot see from here. And his son, who was Louis XVI, had his head cut off, probably over there on the plaza. I'm not exactly sure. Most of the guillotinings were done on the place of the revolution. It's now Place de la Concorde. And this historical part of Paris, now part of the great center of the massive metropolis, was in medieval times at the edge of town. The main part of the city was back up that way. The Louvre itself was built on the city walls hundreds and hundreds of years ago. But the city has grown. By the time of the revolution, it had grown beyond here and was a mile or two out that way, out the Champs-Élysées. If you could see beyond the Egyptian obelisk, we could see the Arch of Triumph, the victory of Napoleon and the revolution, and the liberal forces, as it were. And that was where the edge of city was when Thomas Jefferson came here. This plaza was here, and those buildings that you couldn't see but the roofs were here when Thomas Jefferson was here. But that glass-roofed palace over there That was not here when Thomas Jefferson came here during the American Revolution to help arrange for the freedom of the U.S. from Britain. And that famous tower over there hiding behind the tree, the Eiffel Tower, was not here either. That wasn't built for another 100 years after Jefferson, the late 1800s. Incidentally, there's a saying, let's see, who was it? I don't think it was Victor Hugo. I think it might have been Emile Zola. Like a number of people at the time, he hated the Eiffel Tower because it stuck up like a big sore metal thumb. But he kept going up in it day after day. He kept visiting all the time and going up to see the view. And they asked him why, if he hated the Eiffel Tower so much, why he kept going up in it. And he said, well, it's the only place I can go in Paris where I don't have to look at it.
My question is about the doctoral and to watch young girls. And now this is into things about the world. Thank you. Yes?
Bon anniversaire! Just to give you an idea of how old this park is, it says here that this sculptor, born at Lyon, known between 1684 and 1711, carved this statue called the Tiber, that is the Tiber River, out of marble in 1688, 1689, and 1690. This statue was placed in the garden of the Tuileries in 1719. And this plaque, I guess, was made in 1765. Now this is the statue of the Tiber River. It appears to have some little children gathered on the shore at the beach. The water's flowing out of his springs, and he's resting. He is the Tiber River. Now, keep in mind that that statue's been in this park for almost 300 years.